The last decade, we've seen stand replacing wildfires that are uncharacteristic of their historic fire regime moving across the landscape. And they continue to get larger and larger as the years go by.
Prescribed fire is a very useful tool, and here in the west, especially on the east side of the Cascade Mountains, those forests over there were fire-adapted forests.
It's a very visual experience. I mean, you see the change instantly.
We really need to think about its habitat on the landscape and maybe creating fire sheds. You know, these are really creating a home for fire.
The more you mess with fire, the more bases you better have covered. Part of my fascination with fire is tied to that scale issue, because at that smallest scale, fire is imminently predictable. But at that largest scale, fire is ultimately unpredictable. You know, we really have no idea, and that makes it magical.
To me, fire is like water. It's like oxygen. It's like soil. It's like microbes in the soil. It's part of the whole picture. It's part of the environment.
And I think that it's a true benefit that the College of Forestry is now offering a complete fire science curriculum. And I think it'll help guide, engage the students in what they need to know.
We now have multiple perspectives under one house that are very strong programs that can all work together to really look at, you know, how do we transition to this future where fire becomes part of how we live, part of what we do, part of our public acceptance.
I mean, some of these fires that we've been at are, you know, thousands and thousands of acres. And it's not that they're gone, they've just been instantly transformed.
If we don't have the ability to understand fire and its effects on the landscape, then we're not able to treat the landscape both in an economically feasible way or an ecologically appropriate way. So I think this fire science program is very important.
I can come out here and years from now, I'll be able to reference what I've seen and learned out here.
We can give them concepts in the classroom, but until you actually place it on the landscape, you never really understand fully how those concepts fit into this bigger picture in the forest.